When Dr. Donald Brightsmith arrived in southeastern Peru in 1999, he inherited some worn-out gear, a small group of artificial and natural macaw nests, and a clay lick that he thought parrots ate to protect them from the toxins in their diets. But thanks to 20 years of hard work and nearly 40 scientific publications, Don, Gabriela Vigo, and their armies of collaborators from Texas A&M and beyond have learned a great deal about the parrots and macaws of southeastern Peru. Their studies of clay licks have repeatedly shown that parrots eat the soil as a source of dietary sodium, not a protection from dietary toxins. They discover that clay lick used by macaws and parrots varies greatly throughout the year. Nearly all species' clay lick use peaks during the breeding season, specifically when the birds have small chicks in the nest. And even more interesting, macaws feed a great deal of clay lick soil to their nestlings, suggesting clay licks may be a key resource for raising future generations of macaws. Since 1999, their teams of assistants have monitored over 90 different macaw nests. They have found that the most popular nests are the large ones that were used last year, and that macaws fight bitterly to occupy these favorite nests. They found that the leading cause of macaw chick death is starvation. Macaw parents provide differential parental care to their chicks, favoring the first-hatched and neglecting subsequent-hatched individuals. Nearly half of all second-hatched chicks starve, and all third and fourth chicks are let to starve. The fate of the second chick seems tied up in age and developmental differences. Fortunately, they use this knowledge to refine and test wild macaw foster parent techniques, and they are very proud to announce that 100% of the 30 foster chicks were accepted by their new parents, and nearly all fledged into the rainforests of Peru. After 20 years of intense research in southeastern Peru, the Brightsmith group is ready for new challenges. They will redouble their efforts to help species in areas where they are truly endangered and help implement direct conservation actions throughout the Americas. They are now ready to fledge. A new decade, a new phase.